कैसे मॉर्निंग वाला आप लोग। सो बिफोर क्लास फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल्स कंप्लीटेड। सो व्हाट अबाउट फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल्स इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रोटॉन्स न्यूट्रॉन्स। आई हैव गिवन द प्रॉपर्टीज आल्सो गिवन। So, what about fundamental particles? Mass given, charges given, discharge given, and spin also given. Now, fundamental particles: electrons, protons, neutrons. Further atomic terms given. What is called atomic number? What is called mass number? How to represent atomic number and mass number? Representation method also given. Then some important terms. These are also completed. So what are isotopes? Already completed. Same atomic numbers but different mass numbers are called isotopes. Elements having same atomic numbers but different mass numbers. For example, I have given, so 1H1, 1H2, 1H3. Protium, deuterium, tritium. Elements having same atomic numbers 1, 1, 1, but different mass numbers 1, 2, 3 are called isotopes. That is completed. Then isobars. Okay, what have given? Different elements having same mass numbers are called isobars. Elements are different, atomic numbers are different, but having same mass numbers are called isobars. Okay, I have given argon and calcium. So argon and calcium, so 18, 20, atomic numbers are different but having same mass numbers 40 here 40. Series. Different atomic numbers but same mass numbers are called isobars. That is also completed. Then isotopes. So what I have learned about isotopes? So elements are having generally different atomic numbers, different mass numbers, but having same number of neutrons. Neutrons are same, are called isotopes. Okay, what I have given examples isotopes. What about isotopes example? Otherwise, carbon 6.
Potassium.
Okay, what we know? Potassium and
calcium.
And calcium 20, 40 series. So here, different atomic numbers, different mass numbers, but having same number of neutrons. Same number of neutrons. Neutrons are same. How to calculate number of neutrons? Number of neutrons equals to A minus Z. Mass number minus atomic number. So here, what is the mass number? 39. 39 minus 19, that is nothing but 20. number of neutrons in potassium 20, calcium also 20, are called isotones. Next, I have given isoelectronic species. Isoelectronics. Isoelectronic species. So here, what I have given about isoelectronic species, having same number of electrons. Whatever the species having same number of electrons, iso, same, electronic, electrons. Okay, for example, so best example I have given N minus 3, O minus 2, F minus, so and so on. For example, here not only that, Na plus, Mg plus 2. So here, what we are observed, all these species having 10 electrons only. So nitrogen N minus 3, 7 plus 3, 10. 8 plus 2, 10. 9 plus 1, 10. 11 minus 1, 10. And 12 minus 2, 10. See, these all species having 10 electrons only. So everything, nitrogen atomic number 7, we know that minus 3 means addition of 3 electrons, 7 plus 3, 10. Oxygen atomic number 8, minus 2 means addition of 2 electrons, so 10, 10, 10, 10, same number of electrons, isoelectronic species, that is completed. Next, isosters. So what have you given about isosters? Isosters means having same number of atoms and along with electrons. Having same number of atoms and along with electrons. Atoms are same, electrons also same. That is called isosters. Okay, for example, simply N2 plus CO. Isosters means N2 plus CO. See this? So here, total number of atoms, 2. 2 nitrogens. And here, 1 carbon oxygen, 2. Number of atoms are same. 2, 2. At the same time, electrons also same. Here, each nitrogen 7 electrons, 7 into 2, 14 electrons. So carbon 6, oxygen 8, 8 plus 6, 14, 14, 14 equal. Having same number of atoms along with the same number of electrons. Atoms are same, electrons are same, are called isosters. Isosters. Now, the last one, see, isodiapers. Listen, isodiapers. So here, what are isodiapers? So here, isodiapers means, these are the atoms, generally, these are atoms having, the atoms having, atoms having same difference in number of neutrons and protons. See?
So there,
so what are isodiapers? What we can say about isodiapers? Isodiapers means these are the atoms having same difference same difference in number of neutrons and protons. See, atoms having same difference in number of so neutrons and protons. Neutrons and protons. Okay, see, what a confusion this one. Now, what are isodiapers? So these are atoms having, same difference in, number of neutrons and protons. Okay, what is the meaning of it? For example, I have taken potassium and fluorine. See, best example. So, isodiapers. So, if you can take the best example, see, potassium and fluorine. So, K. So, what is the atomic number of potassium? We know that 19. What about its mass number?
39.
And fluorine. Yeah. Same is atomic number.
9.
And its mass number?
19.
Okay, see here. Isodiapers means, so these are the atoms having same difference in number of neutrons and protons. Generally, number of protons are different. Here, how many protons are present in potassium?
19.
Very good, 19. What about fluorine, number of protons?
9.
Protons are different. At the same time, neutrons also different. Neutrons. Okay, how many neutrons are present in potassium?
20.
Okay, number of neutrons in potassium equal to 39 minus 19. Mass number minus atomic number. 39 minus 19, that is nothing but 20. So, potassium having number of neutrons 20. What about fluorine?
10.
Neutrons also different. Elements having, otherwise atoms having different protons, different neutrons. Protons are different. Neutrons also different. But, see there. Same difference in number of neutrons and protons. Neutrons, protons, difference is the same. For example, here, neutrons, protons, difference. Neutrons, how many here? 20. So, number of neutrons in potassium, 20. 39 minus 19, 20. Minus difference. Protons 19. That is equal to how much? 1. Difference in number of neutrons and protons. Here, with respect to potassium, the difference in number of neutrons and protons, that is equal to 1. Okay, like that. Say, what about fluorine? So, what about neutrons here?
10.
Okay, what about protons?
9.
Equals to 1. See, are called isodiapers. So isodiapers means what have given atoms having. Generally, these are the atoms having different protons, different neutrons. Only protons wise difference, neutrons wise difference, but same difference in number of neutrons and protons. Neutrons, protons, differently are so that is the equal, both having same, one, one. So this type of set of atoms are called isodiapers. What we can say that? Isodiapers. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So at the same time, okay, so our gains and advanced point of view, lead point of view, are nuclear isomers. So nuclear isomers. So generally, nuclear isomers. What are nuclear isomers? Atoms with same atomic numbers and same mass numbers. Atomic numbers are same, mass numbers are same, but with different radioactive properties. Different radioactive properties. Okay, radioactive properties means like radium. We know that which elements are emits radiations on its own. Generally, radioactive element means, for example, we know that radium. Now, so what I have given nuclear isomers. So here, what are nuclear isomers? Generally, atoms having same atomic numbers required. For example, if you can take uranium. Uranium, U. So generally, uranium is a radioactive element. So uranium having same atomic numbers, uranium X, and uranium Z. So these two uranium, whatever the uranium which having same atomic numbers 92 92, same mass numbers also, same mass number 235 235. So we don't know that what about the uranium mass number, atomic number, just listen. So uranium X, uranium Z, these atoms are having same atomic numbers 92 92, at the same time same mass numbers also 235 235, but different radioactive properties are present. Radioactive. Radioactivity means, so which substance emits radiations on its own? So here, different radioactive properties are present. For example, one of the important radioactive property, half-life. So half-life means, particularly this half-life properties present for radioactive elements. Generally, each radioactive substance having this half-life properties appear. Half-life means given substance, given radioactive compound. So after certain period of time, it is decomposed. It is decomposed exactly in its amount half. For the decomposition takes time. That is called half-life. For example, uranium, uranium X. So I have taken 1 gram. After certain period of time, so exactly here 1.4 minutes like that. So that is exactly the amount converted as a half amount. That is called half-life. So it's half-life 1.4 minutes. But here this half-life 6.7 hours. This half-life is approximately 6.7 hours. So here it can take time just 1.4 minutes. So it is one of the property, radioactive property. Half-life is the one of the important radioactive property. All radioactive elements are shows this property, half-life property, half-life. So how much time? 6.7 hours. The uranium Z exactly converted as a half amount. That is called half-life. But here uranium X and uranium Z both have same atomic numbers, 92, 92. Same mass numbers, 235, 235, but here different radioactive properties are there. Different radioactive properties are there. The type of atoms are called nuclear isomers. Nuclear isomers. So what are nuclear isomers? Atoms are having same atomic numbers, same mass numbers, but different radioactive properties are called nuclear isomers. Okay, these all are most important. See, isotopes followed by isobars, then isotones, isoelectronic species, isosters, isodiapers, and nuclear isomers. Now, so before I have given Dalton's atomic theory, what I have given, matter is made up of molecules. Molecules are made up of atoms. So here Dalton's given atomic theory about atom. The first atomic theory was proposed by Dalton only. So according to theories, see. Before I have given matter, anything which has some mass and occupies some space, that is called matter, whatever it is. Different types of matters are there. Our surroundings, everything referred as a matter. So matter is made up of molecules. Molecules are made up of atoms. Okay. In this case, Dalton's so given theory, that is called Dalton's atomic theory. About atom he was given, so it is called Dalton's atomic theory. So about atom, the first theory was proposed by Dalton only, that is called Dalton's atomic theory. Okay, what about Dalton's atomic theory? What about Dalton's atomic theory? Listen. So according to Dalton's first one, so matter is made up of small indivisible particles called atoms. Indivisible. Not divisible, indivisible, not divisible. So any matter is made up of small indivisible particles. These are called atoms. According to Dalton, indirectly, atoms are indivisible, not divisible. These are only smallest final particles. So at the same time, Dalton's given, atoms can neither be created nor destroyed. So atoms can be neither be created nor destroyed. So at the same time, one more. So atoms of a given element are identical in properties. Atoms of a given element are identical in properties. For example, given element O3 is there. Three atoms are there. O3, three oxygen. These having identical properties are present. Three oxygen atoms have. So atoms of given element having identical in properties. Okay, next one. Atoms of different elements in different properties. For example, different elements are there. For example, H2 element is there, O2 element is there. Here hydrogen atom properties are different. Here oxygen atom properties are different. So not only that, atoms of different elements combined in a fixed ratio to form molecule of a compound. According to Dalton's atomic theory, atoms of different elements, for example H2 plus O2 combined, we get H2. Atoms of different elements combined in a fixed ratio to form a molecule. Fixed ratio, generally H2O may. So 2 grams of hydrogen, 16 grams of oxygen. That ratio is the fixed. These are the main important postulates in Dalton's atomic theory. So what are the main postulates in Dalton's atomic theory? According to Dalton, matter is made up of small indivisible particles. These small indivisible, not divisible, these particles are called atoms. Secondly, atoms can be neither be created nor destroyed. That is second one. Atoms can be neither be created nor destroyed. Third one, atoms of same element matlab O3, ozone diya. Ozone mein three oxygen atoms are there. These three oxygen atoms having identical properties. Next one, atoms of different elements. For example, I have given H2 atom and O2 atom. Either hydrogen, either oxygen. These two. So these two properties are different. The last one. Atoms of different elements combined in a fixed ratio. For example, see, fixed ratio means H2 plus O2. Combined, we get H2O. Here, we take like this, balancing pair. So fixed ratio means it is a 2:1 ratio. See this. So 2 moles of hydrogen combines with 1 mole of oxygen. We get 2 moles of water. It is a compound. Atoms of different elements combine fixed ratio to form a molecule of a compound. These are the main postulates in Dalton's atomic theory. So here some drawbacks also there. Drawbacks, these are also called limitations. Limitations matlab kya hai? Drawbacks. Okay, Dalton's theory, limitations, drawbacks. What are the drawbacks? First of all, see, it is not explained. This Dalton's atomic theory not explained about chemical combination. Why the atoms are combined to form a compound? The chemical combination, it is not explained, Dalton atomic theory. At the same time, it does not give an idea about isotopes and isobars. Dalton's atomic theory not explained. What about isotopes? What about isobars? At the same time, it fails to explain. It is not explained why atoms of different elements show different properties. Why? Why the atoms of different element shows different properties, mass different, size different. Why different elements of atom shows different properties? It is also not explained Dalton's atomic theory. At the same time, it does not explain the difference between an atom and a molecule. Dalton's atomic theory not explained what is the difference between atom and molecule. That is one of the drawbacks, limitation. Dalton atomic theory does not explain chemical combination, why the atoms are combined to form molecule. It is also not given proper explanation, Dalton's atomic theory. So it is also one of the drawbacks, limitation. At the same time, it is not given any idea about isotopes and isobars. Okay, before I have given what about isotopes and isobars, but Dalton atomic theory not given any idea about on isotopes and isobars. So one more, it is not explained why the atoms of different elements shows different properties like mass, size, etc. So the last one what I have given, it does not explain the difference between atom and molecule. These all are drawbacks. Drawbacks are nothing but what we can say, limitations. Limitations in Dalton's atomic theory. So Dalton's given some properties given. So along with the Dalton's atomic theory, there's some limitations also there. What about limitations? Drawbacks. The drawbacks are nothing but limitations. Okay, understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Any doubt here in Dalton's atomic theory?